Well, normally I come on stage at leadership conference on day three to give a speech, to share my parting thoughts and encouragement before you head home to put all of your newly inspired plans into action. But today, I thought I'd take a different approach and have a sit-down conversation with someone I greatly admire. I've had the privilege of speaking with this woman many times, and she was a great friend of my grandmother. Well, you've already soaked in her wisdom here at Leadership Conference, and now we'll take a pause and a breath during our last day together to have an unscripted chat with this highly successful Mary Kay leader. Would you please help me welcome back Independent Elite Executive National Sales Director Emeritus, Anne Newbury. So thank you so much for being here and just sharing your wisdom with us and your tireless devotion to this incredible company. You're so loved and so appreciated. I just want to let you know that again.
Well, I appreciate that, and I must tell you that it's a joy to work with you, and you are your father's son. That's the nicest compliment I can pay you.
Yeah, from the hairline down.
Well, I wasn't going to go there, but that's
Well, Anne, we've talked a lot during this leadership conference about being all in on direct selling and all in on Mary Kay. What does direct selling mean to you, and why do you think Mary Kay is so special in our industry?
Well, direct selling is the heart and core of entrepreneurialism in America. And it's each of these consultants can build their own independent business, part-time, full-time, reach every consumer hands-on, teach them the product line, help them to look and feel better and be their best. And what better way is there to do that than one-on-one situation? And Mary Kay leads the industry because we're the only teaching-oriented company there is out there in direct sales. Our consultants are trained to really know this product line, and each customer benefits in the process. You can't say that about any other direct sales company.
No, that's very true. And I always like to describe Mary Kay, but you know, in our industry, in the direct selling industry, there's a spectrum of different companies.
Huge.
On one end of the spectrum, you have the companies that really their associates, or whatever they may call them, are just glorified order takers walking around with a catalog. And on the other end, there's people that don't know how to sell anything, but we're going to make a lot of money. That's all they just say. They're just snake oil salespeople.
Period.
Mary Kay's so great because we're a hybrid and we're in the middle, where we've got beauty consultants that can work part-time and just make the extra $50 to help with their family expenses, to a career path where people can go all the way to the top and succeed by helping other people learn this business and having success on their own terms. It's not replicated by anyone else in our industry. And it's been that way since the beginning, and other people have tried to change their stripes and be more like us, but
can't happen.
Can't beat the original.
We're the only company where the beginning consultant can make an honest to goodness, substantial, generous hourly profit. And then she can move her way up if she wants to, if she's ever ready. But what a great business she can have being a beauty consultant and servicing all those customers. It's amazing.
I agree. You know, in thinking about being all in and the power of direct selling to change people's lives, I couldn't believe this the other day, but I stumbled across a quote. A marketing magazine had interviewed my dad, in the 80s, at some point in the 80s. And I thought this quote was so great, I don't think I'll ever forget it, actually. But What he said was most companies create a sales force to enhance the value of the product that they make. But Mary Kay created a product to enhance the value of the sales force that she built.
What that means is that before she ever opened the door to ask anyone to help her with it, she had a first-class degree of creation people who made that product superior from day one, and the continued staff that we have that redoes that product line and improves it day in and day out, 55 years now, that's why we're still the best, and it works. That's all I can say. Skincare products work.
We're all in on putting skincare on your faces.
Every one of them. There's 95 million of them. I told them that yesterday. We're going to get them all, honey, for this year.
You know, we have... We at Mary Kay, we have, for employees, we have this thing called the Circle of Honor, and it's for all the employees that have spent more than 10 years with the company. And we do a pretty big luncheon every year to celebrate that. And I get the honor of sitting in the reserved seating at the front with the employees that are celebrating special milestones, 25, 35, sure. 40 years. And I sat with an employee, I think she had like, don't quote me on this, 31, 32 years of tenure with the company. And she looked at me and she said, you know, I've worked for Mary Kay for 32 years and I've lived in Dallas my whole life. I've never been approached by a Mary Kay beauty consultant about skincare products.
That's true. It's true. The
opportunity. So if you think
huge.
If you don't think there's 95 million people out there, come on.
Good percentage right now.
Still find them. Okay, well, I want to talk a little bit about relevance. And you hear so much about the way consumers are changing the way that they shop and the expectation of how they want to receive their products, and that includes beauty products. So what do you think about Mary Kay still being relevant with consumers?
Well, it's almost comical because they still don't want to go to the malls, but they're still at the malls because you can't find a parking place when you go. But all these people who want to shop at home, online and all that stuff, and they waste their time receiving it. Wasn't the right size, wasn't the right color, packed up, shipped back, effort. All they gotta do is make a phone call to us. We're right there, ready to shine, snow or sleet. We do the whole facial, we do the party. We make them feel like $1 million. They're paid, delivered on the spot. And how much better can it be than that?
All right. Yeah, the consumers have this perception that if they see something on their mobile phone and they want it delivered to their house by 5 o'clock that day, who better to capitalize on that than us?
Oh yeah, we're ready to shine all night long, day, morning, noon, and night, 24/7, 24/7 service.
And with regard to our culture and the beliefs that Mary Kay and the values that Mary Kay started this business on, can you talk a little bit about the relevance of those and which one resonates the most with you?
Well, bless her heart, of course, the golden rule, it's just so simple. If you treat other people the way you would want to be treated in every aspect of their lives, you'll be rewarded in the process, and you'll get treatment back. And she declared the first time I ever met her, she talked so simply about, from day one, I took God as my partner to start this company, and he has never, never let us down through all these years, and she always believed he never would, nor did he. So she said, put God first in your life and your family second and your job third, and you're gonna be, you know, just success all the way through. But then she was very clear to say the job third, not eighth, ninth, or tenth place. So put it up there in that priority. She knew that women's priorities were in order that way, that they would always be happy, self-fulfilled, and in the right place at the right time. So it's wonderful. Making other people feel important. That was another thing she taught us. Big sign. Every single one of us needs to feel important, needs to have a hug, needs to be listened to. We're all important. And she always said, if you take the time to hear another person's heart, you'll be on a winning track. And it's so true. So how many more values are better than all that?
Yeah.
If you just practice them, you gotta practice what you preach.
And there's one more that we didn't discuss in there, and that's the go-give spirit. But I know of no other company. I think we have that trademarked.
they'll give. I'm not sure. But I don't know of any other company that encourages its people to enthusiastically give into the lives of others as a strategy for it to come back into their own.
That's right. And without worrying about who's getting paid for it financially, it's paychecks of the heart. If we all just each take care of each other, see to it that it's being done the right way all the time, we're going to have first-class success forever and feel better about it, too.
Well, I want to talk to you a little bit, Anne, about working with people. I know you were second to none when it comes to working with people and getting to know their why. Can you share your thoughts about why that's still so important in this business today?
Because you can't just talk at people and tell them what to do. If we're not a boss and this is not an employee. This is an individual that we have promised great opportunities if they'll just follow our leadership. So if I don't know why she wants to go out and make an honest living, then how can I motivate her? I mean, she's not going to do what I tell her to do. She's going to do what drives her from within. So you got to tell me what you're willing to work for, Ryan, so I can help you know how much money it's going to take to get it and how fast you're going to earn that. And then I'm going to help celebrate that with you. We have to get wonderful things to happen in your family financially in order to have everything else come out
okay.
Right. And that's my interest in you, is to see that this works for you at every level that you need to have it happen.
What if her why was that she just wanted to buy the products at a discount? What would you say?
I'd say, we're not going to do that, honey, because you're better off having your great consultant take care of you as a hostess and as a preferred client and get everything you need at that level, because if we're just allowing you to be what we call a personal use consultant, which never was in the book, by the way. Mary Kay, if she were here, would call it PU.
Yeah, yeah.
How can you make a profit on something you're just putting on your own face?
Can't do it.
So, yeah, I would rather than be a preferred customer and everybody who gets a showcase and buys product at wholesale is out making a wonderful hourly profit and building a business.
All right, so I'm going to take a page from Laura Beitler's book. Some of you may recall when she interviewed David Hole at the 50th anniversary Mary Kay seminar, where they have a lightning round in the middle of their interview. The questions aren't as difficult as they were with David. They're embarrassing. So, Anne, I would like to know what the silliest thing you have ever had to do in your Mary Kay career, or the silliest outfit you've ever had to wear.
I was a sales director, and my little unit was known as the Pink Pilgrims of Mary Kay, because we were the first to land in Boston, Massachusetts. About 200 of them here tonight, by the way. So you have friends of time now to entertain you at seminar. We didn't have any of that. We had each other. And on the evenings, we would have skit night, and each unit had to submit an application to be on a skit show. So our little pink pilgrims came all the way down, and we had made homemade long pink pilgrim dresses with little white fluffy hats that would look like little pilgrim doughboys. And we got on stage and sang this song. Actually, it was Daryl's song, James Taylor, "You Got a Friend," except you didn't have a friend, you had a pilgrim. Morning, noon, and night, cleanser, mask, or lotion, ring us any hour, you have a pilgrim. We thought we were wonderful. Everybody else laughed us off the stage, but that's okay. I think it was after that Mary Kay said, let's pay for some professional.
Well, as a member of the Mary Kay staff, and you saw Mr. Worldwide Wow earlier, you know, we get to wear our fair share of funny things. And I remember one time when we were opening our manufacturing plant in Hangzhou, China, for our Chinese market, David Hole and I were invited to go over and christen this new manufacturing facility. We get there, and they have the entrance lobby and like the little portico shape that's there. They have it decorated like the bow of a cruise ship. And of course, we go in, and not till the very last minute did they explain that they had sailor outfits for us, and we were going to be the captains of the Mary Kay, SS Mary Kay China manufacturing plant, and break the champagne across the bow and everything else. And David still wears his sailor suit. Okay. If you were going.
He has a special need we don't know about.
Was that?
Does that mean he has a special need we don't know about?
Well, he knew I was going to attack him when he had no chance to defend himself, but I don't think he expected me to.
It'll either get me a promotion or get me fired. I'm not sure. It's true.
I think you had the immunity necklace.
Good.
I think I did too.
I would sincerely hope so.
All right, moving on. I might get fired, actually. If you were going to stock up on a Mary Kay product, which one can you not live without?
Oh my goodness. Volume firm.
Yeah.
I need the whole action. Mercy me. I met somebody on a cruise ship a month ago, recognized me, hadn't seen her in 45 years, so help me God, we used to carpool together. She said, "You haven't changed a bit." That's when I knew. Volume firm, thank you very much.
I imagine you probably sold her a set.
I said that to her. She said, "No, I don't think so." I said, "I do."
Well, I got in a little bit of trouble in the first conference because the product that I absolutely love, that I did stock up on because we discontinued it, was Targeted Action Eye Revitalizer. But then, after our marketing folks basically tackled me backstage for mentioning a discontinued product, I was reminded that the active ingredient in Targeted Action Eye Revitalizer is also in the Volume Firm Eye Renewal Cream in the Timewise Repair Set. So, apparently I've been double dipping for all these years.
You might have been the advice of a beauty consultant.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to brush up on my flip chart. All right, what about this? What about the favorite Mary Kay trip that you've earned?
Oh, goodness, I bet, no question. It was 1982, and it was the very first time Mary Kay had the top 10 national sales directors. So we had to qualify. There were about 30 of us then, and we had to qualify to be in that top 10. So I had to work to do it, but the trip that I won was going to London, Geneva, and Paris, staying at the Ritz-Carlton, George Sank, and all that, but we flew on the Concorde.
Wow.
We had the whole plane to ourselves.
Wow.
And it was the most amazing experience of my life. I will never forget it, and when I saw that video, it said, "This is what we want to do for you." I said, "It's mine. I'm going to work to do that."
So you've
never
been,
forgot it.
You've been supersonic.
I have been.
That's pretty
You
that's
get up there
cool.
above where the air is all clear. I was supersonic before I got on the plane, though.
Right. Just raise your hand if you've been supersonic. Couple.
Well, it's been a while since we had the Concorde, so if they got to do it, that's special.
That would be a dream of mine. I got to figure out a way to do that.
Maybe get them to make one so you can have it.
All right, one of the last ones here, we're going to wrap it up. What about this? What was your all-time favorite memory of Mary Kay Ash?
Well, certainly there are a lot, but I have to say, I was a new director, fairly new director, and she came up to Boston to do a big program for us, a big program. We only had 2 units. But anyway, they stayed over, and she and Mel, I took them out to lunch the next day before the airport, and we went. And remember, she was not famous then. This just goes back to the mid-70s, so no one had, she'd never written a book, none of that. And we went to the restaurants. I didn't bother, she would not have been recognized, the lady, cute girl, took the order. And for our clam chowder, she wanted lobster and left the table. Mary Kay dropped her smile, swelled up like a prune, looked at me and said, "Why aren't you going to do your job?" Momentarily, I thought, "Do what?" And I thought, "Oh, okay, I'm sorry." So when she brought the food back, I had to reach in my purse and get my business card. Thank God I had them with me. And give it to her and said, "You've been so sweet to us today. I want to do something special for you. Have you ever heard of Mary Kay Cosmetics? No? Well, let me be the first to introduce it to you. This is my card. If I could just have your name and number, I'll be calling you and give you a complete complimentary Mary Kay facial and makeover, and you're going to love it. Tell me you're going to love it." That's what I want to say. You don't know who I'm performing in front of right now. Anyway, cute girl took my card, and I took hers. So help me God. A week later, my phone rings. "Honey, it's Mary Kay. Did you book that girl I met last week?" "Yes, yes, I did. Thank God I can say, yes, I booked her, and it's next week." And it's like, that's who she was. On my case, 24/7. 1 year I came off the stage. I've been in the court every year recruiting. And she, every year she'd go, "What's it going to be next year? What's it going to make?" Finally, a third year in a row, I looked at her and said, "Are you ever going to let up?"
No.
She swelled up again. Swelled. She always was, she rose 2 inches every time she did that. She said, "No, I'm not. And you wouldn't want me to." That's what we as nationals do for our people.
I remember talking to Mary Kay on the phone when I went away to college. She'd always say, "When are you going to hurry up and graduate so you can come work for me?"
Right.
And I was like, "Well, you know, you can only graduate so fast. We'll only let you take so many classes
at once."
But my favorite memory was in 2001 when my dad came back out of retirement and came to seminar and gave that awesome Mary Kay Way speech, and I was there on day one of that seminar, day one of the first one of those seminars. Hard to believe in 2001 we still used VHS tapes, but we got a VHS tape of that opening general session, and my dad and I took it over to my grandmother's house, and popped it in her VCR, and watched it with her, and it was just, I'll never forget just the calm that came over her knowing that Dad was back, I was there, things were going great, and we listened to that speech, and I'll never forget it. It was such a great memory.
And thank goodness you did it for her, because that did bring her a lot of peace, I'm sure.
And I do remember about her relentlessness, of the never give up. I remember also when she couldn't come to my college graduation. It was 1998, and she had her strokes, and she was essentially at home full time. So my school I went to, SMU, is just, you know, right around the corner from her house. So I went by her roundhouse on Lupton Circle and rolled in there with my cap and gown and everything. And it was so hard to have those one-way conversations with her. So I grabbed her hand and I said, "You know, Mary Kay, I graduated college, went to my graduation game." She squeezed my hand so tight, and I said, "Anne, I graduated in 3 years, and I was, you know, summa cum laude," and she squeezed my hand so tight, and I said, "Anne, I got my first job, I'm going to go work for PricewaterhouseCoopers," and she let go of my hand and rolled over.
You
could still communicate.
I dare say.
Well, I'd like to close with this, Anne, and I'm just going to let you take the show here. If Mary Kay were here today, what do you think she would want everyone in this audience to hear right now?
I think she would say, "Please continue to take my dream. Take my dream for yourself, your families, every person you come in contact with, and help them to understand that my dream was always for every woman to reach the pinnacle of her dream success, and that through our plan and through our devotion to you and through our product being as great as it is, that we have your best interest at heart, and we know you can do it. We know you can do it. Everything that you hold deeply, steadfastly in your mind and soul, you can do it. And I'm counting on you to do that. That's what she would have said.
That's great.
Well, thank you so much. It has been a pleasure spending this time with you and sharing your experience and wisdom. We just can't thank you enough.
You're precious. We're thrilled to have you at the helm, Ryan. We love you all very much.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand and give Anne Newbury one more huge round of applause.